All right, now that we've got the toe stop base and the cleat pin drawn, we're gonna go ahead and draw an isometric view of the toe stop cleat. So that cleat is just that top piece that fits in there. When I look at it over here and the one that's already drawn, we can see we've got the overall shape. We have this cylinder coming through. That cylinder has a hole going through it, but we also have that little sloped area back there, those angles. Those are going to be shown as hidden lines. So I'm going to break this video or this series into three parts. The first part, I'm just going to draw the overall base of, you know, the overall, I don't want to call it base because we actually have a base in this project, but the overall shape of this. I'll come back in another video and put in that cylinder, and I'll come back in another video and I'll put in those hidden lines just so we can break it down into kind of more bite-sized chunks. So we're just going to worry about this overall shape right here. All right, so let's come over here. Now, what we do know, I'll go back to my little help sheet that I have. And so what we do know is, just looking at the sketch, we already drew this. These circles, kind of like the base, have a diameter of 4, or that would be a radius of 2. And then it goes back just like the base does. It's outside of that radius of 2, then it goes back an additional 2.125. So we're just going to focus on that right now. And this smaller part right here goes down. If I look at my sketch, let's bring the sketch over. It'll be easier to show you that way. If I look, it's see, it's got a radius of 2. So from center out is a 2, and then we're adding in 2.125, but this little part right here is a depth of 1. The whole thing is a depth of 3. So let's go back to our CAD drawing and let's get started. So we'll do some ISO circles. We are like expert ISO circle makers by now, aren't we? I enter for ISO circle. We're gonna do a diameter of 4. Well, I could have done a radius of 2. all right, so we've got this, and we're going to go ahead and bring this out. Remember how we did that construction line before where I brought it out when we were doing that base? And I went ahead and made it the radius, which is 2, and then I copied it from side to side. Let's just go ahead and make it 4.125. So it's 2 to the edge of this circle, and then the additional 2.125. So we're gonna just make a line 4.125. We're gonna save a little extra time here. So we've got that. That's the overall to the very edge. Now that we have that, we're gonna copy it, select it, press enter, anywhere for a base point. We're gonna copy it over. Remember, it's a radius of 2. And we're gonna copy it this way, 2. Perfect. We don't need this line anymore. We were just trying to get that overall top shape. Now we're gonna draw a line from here to here. We can trim as we go. You know, I like to trim as I go, so trim. All right, that looks good. So we've got that overall shape right here. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna come and we're gonna go down. Remember, that's a distance of 1. This one is that 2.125. So we'll just draw lines, easy. We'll click here. Oops, I say easy. We got to hit a 5 to be able to go down, or I do. 1, we're going to come back this direction, a 5, 2.125. And if we've already come down 1, the overall is 3. We're going to make this 1, 2. Perfect. That looks so good. All right, now what we're going to do is just copy this top part. We'll trim out what we don't need. We're just going to copy this straight down. A distance of, whoops, I almost did it 3. Almost did it 2. It needs to be 3. Perfect. This looks good. So let's go ahead and draw a line from here to here. And then we'll just trim out what we don't need. Trim this and that. And oh my goodness, this is looking good. So we've got that overall shape. Like I said, we're just gonna stop this video here so we have a nice short little bite size chunk that you can draw. In the next video, I'll come through here and we're gonna do the cylinder down there. And then in the last video, we're gonna do the hidden lines for those angles. You're gonna laugh at how easy this is. It's actually really cool what we're gonna do for that. So yeah, that's it.